Welcome back. We've had a lot of requests for what we can do with instant ramen besides make egg drop soup. So today we're going to do a surf and turf stir fry with fresh vegetables. So let's start out. Here's our ramen, and we've broken that up into four pieces in the bag. And we've got some water boiling here. I'm just going to put that right in. We are not going to put the flavoring packet in this, into making the noodles right now. We're going to use the flavoring packet later with our vegetables. So here's our flavoring packet, and we'll try to remember to use that. So what we're going to do is it's very similar to a stir fry. You want all of the ingredients ready. The little bit of difference here, though, is that we are going to put in the vegetables in the order that we want them to cook. And we're going to cook at a very high heat, and some of the things will take longer than others to cook. And so we'll put those in first, and then we'll gradually put in the other ingredients. You'll notice here, we're going to be grilling, and it's 600 degrees, so we're grilling at a pretty high temperature. And the first thing I'm going to put in is I'm going to put in the beet. This is a nice fresh beet. And what we're going to do is we're just going to cut this into bite-sized pieces, just like this. Bite-sized pieces. And again, you'll see that I'm using the side of the blade as a guide for cutting the vegetables, just like that. And now I'll use this as a scoop. We'll bring those right over here. This is very hot right now. I'm just going to toss those right in. And they're going to begin to roast. Let's look in on the noodles. And they are beginning to soften up. We don't want to get them too soft. So what I'll do now is I'm just going to turn those right off. And those will continue to cook with their own heat. We'll take one more look at our beets. There we go. And now, the next thing to put in, because it takes a little while for them to cook, will be the carrots. And this is from the garden, and it's been washed, but we don't need to peel them. And what we can do is we can do what's called a roll cut. So I'm cutting them at an angle, and I'm just giving them a bit of a roll as I cut them. So what you end up with is the interior of the vegetable is exposed so that it cooks very quickly. And we'll put those right in right now. And those beets are roasting right up. Again, that's on the highest heat. So the next one we'll put in is we're going to put in a little bit of moisture, and this is an heirloom tomato, just picked from the garden. They're great. One rule you want to remember with fresh tomatoes is never refrigerate them. It really ruins the flavor, and they're actually really sweet when they're just picked and they're a little bit warm. So we'll cut these into bite-sized pieces. Not too small. You can see they're really juicy. Nice sharp knife. This will take a couple scoops. So this will add moisture to the vegetables that are roasting. And with that moisture, this is when we'll sprinkle on some of the flavor packet. Right on the tomatoes, just like a little bit of almost salt and pepper seasoning. But we're using the ramen. Alright. Let's check the noodles one more time. So, we don't want them to get too soft, but we want them to get separated. So they'll be still hot, but al dente and not overcooked. So the next thing we'll put in is we'll put in some zucchini. We're not going to use this whole zucchini. This is too much zucchini. And that's one of the things that happens this time of year. People get too many zucchinis. We'll use half of this one. And we'll just cut that up. Alright. We'll take this in a couple scoops as well. So by this time, the beets have really softened up a little bit. And the carrots are well on their way. You can hear the tomatoes roasting. And when you grill with the cover down, because what that does is it maintains the moisture in whatever is roasting. So the next thing we're going to put in is we're going to put in some of the steak. This is a nice sirloin tip, and what I'll do is I'll cut this into kind of large bite-sized pieces. And what we'll do is we'll marinate this a little bit with some soy sauce. Not a lot, probably maybe a tablespoon or so. And I'll just make sure that that's marinating. When you're grilling steak or other meats, you want to make sure they're as close to room temperature as possible. You don't want to try to grill a frozen steak. And actually, even a refrigerated steak does not grill as well as a room temperature cut. So you want to do that. So I'll get that ready there, let it marinate for a minute or so. Give this another stir. So all of that, the soup base that we've put in now is all dissolved. Some nice flavoring in there. So we're going to put in our steak, and if you want your steak a little more done, this is going to be medium rare. You could put that steak in a little bit earlier, but I like my steak medium rare. So this is going to be in there for maybe 3 minutes or so. Put that right in here. Cover that right up. So the next thing we're going to put in is we're going to put in some shrimp, and I'm just going to put in a couple drops of this hot sesame oil. Right into the shrimp. I think I have maybe 8 shrimp in there, and maybe 1/4 pound of meat. The steak. So let's take a look here. We'll give the steak a stir. So this is a nice little glaze that's forming. In there. Heat up. So the last thing we'll put in is we'll put in some green onions, some scallions. And we'll just cut those at an angle. Give this one more stir. The shrimp's beginning to cook up. And we put that shrimp in last because the worst thing is overcooked seafood. And remember, we're cooking this at, you know, 500-600 degrees at that surface. That's pretty hot. Let's take one more look at our noodles. And they're looking good. That's great. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take advantage of our being outdoors. Look out below. We'll just drain those. Here. So, all right. I think it's been a couple minutes. That shrimp's cooking up. And let's grab the scallions. What I want to do with the scallions is I'm going to squeeze them as I put them in. We'll go one more, get the last of it. Close that for one more minute. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put this in here just so you'll be able to see. There we go. All right. So, there you have it. Nice, quick little surf and turf stir fry with steak and shrimp. And since I forgot my chopsticks, I'll just have to taste it. That's it. We'll see you next time.